A very good morning to everyone present here. I welcome you to this consultation program on the Northeast India Regional Economic Development Policy. We have with us our very distinguished guests who've joined us from New Delhi. So may I please welcome Ministers George Tharathil, Minister Mark Pixley, and Minister Jessica Nis to kindly take their seats. So the program has been divided into two segments. The first segment will be for the four policy sectors, and the second segment will be for the seven state teams. So without any further delay, may I now request Minister George to kindly say a few words.
Well, welcome to all the representatives from the states of Northeast of India. We have a very unique history in the formation of these states in eastern part of India. It has a pre-independence, even pre-British history in a way, and a specific colonial history, and we have a post-colonial or post-independent history that has brought about these seven states from which you all have been invited to this consultation. Given the federal system of Indian administration, or there being a central administration of which we are here in this consultation as representatives of the government of India, and the state representatives that you are, we have a unique position to shape on the basis of this consultation for the future of this region, taking on from the understanding that you provide us of its past and of its present. And therefore, I welcome all of you wholeheartedly to this consultation.
Thank you, Minister. Now we begin with the program. So may I request the first Chief Minister to please come forward.
A very good morning to one and all present here. I'm Prince Gupta, representing the head of the Chief Ministers of the Northeast, and I'll be stating the difficulties which are being faced in the Northeast region and probable solutions which we all have come up with in order to solve them. Northeast is situated in the furthest corner of India, and we are not much connected to the rest part of India because maybe a small corridor is there. Another connectivity with the rest part of the world is not there. And our trade and commerce does not accumulate much to the exports. But we, the Northeast people, are rich in our culture. We have a good holding of our biodiversity and the environment. We look forward with this program to enrich further in our holdings and the situation where we are. So the concerns, after having the meeting with all of them, all the ministers I mean to say, was basically divided into three categories. First was the infrastructure, second was the security, and the third was the environment. The first problem which we face in infrastructure is that we don't have a good developed means of transportation, because of which we are not being able to connect our rural areas to the urban areas, whereas we are not being able to have interstate transactions with each other. The second thing which will add up to our infrastructure is upgradation and resource sharing of medical institutes. We want to establish medical institutes in such a manner so that one state can use the technology of the other, while we can provide better education to the medical students in our institutes. The third is building up business consortium in terms of agricultural produce. We know that most of the products, agricultural products, which are not produced in India, are being imported from the rest of the world. But looking at the climatic conditions of the Northeast, it is possible to produce most of them in our region. So there is a proposal to establish a proper business consortium with collaboration with the agriculture. The third concern is we define literacy in India in a very minute way, but we never define it. We define it in the quantifying way, like literacy is quantified, but we never give a proper quality to that. So with the concerns of some ministers in the Northeast, we say that although our literacy rate is good, we want that quality in it. So quality of education should be provided to them. Moving on to the security, our regions are neighboring the countries like China, Myanmar, and Bangladesh. And in the past, we have seen that we do not have a very good relation with them. Recent times, it shows up to be good, but I think that might be of short term. So we need to have a stability in them because we face a high amount of infiltration with them. So the idea which we have come up is fencing the securities and providing proper corridors so our trade and commerce is not being hampered on that. Another thing is we establish a proper model with which we can indulge the community and the corporate and the state to promote our business so that the clashes can be reduced. The third is regarding the environment. We know that the Northeast region are rich in biodiversity. We want to use our biodiversity by maintaining the forest area cover up to a certain defined limit. And one more suggestion is to develop a disaster management system, particularly for the Northeast, so that if anything happens, they can come up. Thank you. That's all.
May I now request the representative for the Minister of Development to please come forward.
Honorable Ministers, esteemed member of the forum, I, Kritika Upadhyari, Development Minister of Tripura, would be presenting few points regarding the development sector in the Northeast. Our meeting actually started with the brief introduction of Development Minister from all the seven sisters. And we discussed at length what are the issues that we face. There are many issues. Issues are endless. So instead of listing them one by one, we came up with the most important top three issues that we need to focus on now. Because the ministers from Delhi are there, one thing that we would like to point out is that we contribute to over 2.5% of India's GDP, and we have area of 8% and 3.77% of the population, but still we are neglected. So that is one concern we wanted to put. And as far as our priorities are concerned, we want to focus on economic development, definitely, but our infrastructure has gone haywire. As the Chief Minister, sir, has already pointed it out, our roads are bad, and the roads which are being constructed are damaged because of flood in Assam and landslides and other reasons. So the maintenance cost becomes very high. So maybe can we get a technology, or maybe we can focus on research so that we can make roads which do not suffer anything like that. Because of roads, the trade connectivity gets hampered. Industries don't want to come in, because who would want to come in an area which is so far away? And the problems in healthcare emerge. Because if you know, we have some tribes which are located at a distant region, and because of road, we cannot send the medical facilities. Also, we serve as a link between East Asia, South Asia, and Southeast Asia, and still we do not get the infrastructure that we deserve. Our second concern is human resource development. Most of the states have very good literacy rate, but have a low employment. Why? Because we do not have skill-based education. Establishing of IITs and IIMs do not function well because they are concerned more on national level. So we want funds so that we can establish our own state-based institute which focus on our own art and craft, for example, handlooms. Our next focus is on health and sanitation. We do have lack of proper infrastructure and hospitals. There are no doctors, there are no volunteers. And of course, there is limited amount of medical supervision. Basic medical facilities are not there. Sometimes even, the worst thing is that sometimes people don't even reach hospitals. So we may need fund, we need fund in that. And also we face a high burden because all of us know that we belong to area with a high rainfall. So we face a lot of burden because disease like malaria erupt very quickly. And we do not have that kind of funding or infrastructure so that we can support that. Sanitation is not an issue in sense that we have a lot of garbage and anything like that. But the major issue is that we don't have the mechanism to counter the forest waste or even the agricultural waste. So that becomes a problem. Now moving ahead, our next priority is agriculture, handloom and industries. First we would like to start with tea plantation. We do not have proper wages or a policy for a tea plantation worker, so we need assistance for that. And our 94% of the population depends on agriculture and 60% depends on handicraft and handlooms. To be precise, 94% depends on agriculture. Majority of farmers, they do not get technology and we do not have institutes for the development of agricultural technology. And we need more support, maybe like what was done for khadi, maybe if it could be done for bamboo industry, carpet making, wood carving, ornaments, carpentry, etc. We would be really grateful to you if you could forward our suggestion. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Minister. Next up, may I now please call upon the Minister, the representative for the Ministry of Environment to kindly take over.
Very good morning to the respected ministers from the center and the dignitaries presented in the forum. I'm the Environment Minister from the state of Arunachal Pradesh, and now I'll be representing the entire northeastern region for environmental issues. After we had a meeting with all the environmental ministers representing the seven sisters in the northeastern region, we have came up with four main environmental issues. And we have also found out that we are rich in different areas also, that we can utilize and overcome the issues. So we have segregated our talk of the moment as two different sectors. One is the challenges and another is the potential that we can use to cope up with the challenges. The first challenge that we have found out is related to deforestation. There is a lot of jhum cultivation if we talk about the state of Mizoram, where the lands, where the trees are cut down at first and they are then burned and they are fertilized to be cultivated at a future point of time. But it is going in an advanced stage. It should be stopped so that the cutting down of trees can be stopped and afforestation can be maintained. Second is use of firewood household. If it is mainly related to the state of Arunachal Pradesh, where people are using firewood as most of their household uses. Now, if we need to cut it down to take it as a precautionary measure in the future, so that they don't use firewood in a large scale and trees goes out at a certain point of after a certain point of time. So these are related to deforestation. Second issue is related to preservation of animal treasure. Like there is a lot of poaching and hunting in the rural areas. Like in Assam, we have got a great animal treasure as one horned rhino. But they are getting poached for the one horn, and also the related to the entire state of northeastern region, there is a lot of hunting which people do as just an entertainment activity or to satisfy their pleasure. That needs to be stopped anyhow to preserve the animal treasure. Third issue is related to pollution. where there is a lot of air pollution related to again burning of trees and plants that needs to be cut down short. Then there is a lot of smoke emission by the emerging urbanization, so-called urbanization, that is related to smoke emission by the vehicles in the urban areas. Next is carbon emission. There is a lot of industrial development going on these days in the northeastern region, but that is also accompanied by a lot of carbon emission by the industries, and that is polluting. As regards to water pollution, there is a lot of sewage dumping both by the domestic and the industrial sectors. So that needs to be shortened to protect the environment in the long run. And there is also coal mining. With regards to soil pollution, there is a lot of use of pesticides and chemicals for agricultural products, which is to some extent is good for the agricultural base, but if it goes on a huge scale, that is going to be a problem, and we need to hold that to preserve the future environment. And fourth and last issue is related to improper utilization of the natural resources. We all know that Assam is quite rich in so many natural resources, such as rain. There's a lot of rain in the states of, if you talk about Arunachal Pradesh and Assam, there's a lot of rainfall. But people are not utilizing that properly. They can convert it into a lot of alternative sources of energy. Then there is a lot of bamboo, which they can use as an alternative use to plastic. They can use products made of bamboo, which is not done on a huge scale. And third one is ecotourism. We can make use of the already wasted land and make it good as an ecotourism project, so that people get more attracted towards the northeastern region and also the economy gets developed. These are the challenges. And proposed measures that we propose to you in front of you today are we need aid from the government so that we make the people more aware about afforestation. Then we need the education to the concerned people so that they know they have the technical know-how how to use the natural resources in the right way possible and generate funds out of it. Then we need for ecotourism promotion aided by the government, and also we need collaboration from the State Department and the scientific community for combating the pollution. Thank you.
I now request the representative of the Ministers for Security to kindly come forward.
Honorable Ministers of the Union of India, Honorable Chief Ministers, Honorable Ministers representing their respective states and respected dignitaries, I wish you all a very good morning. So I stand here and I represent the Minister of Security and Border Affairs of the different states of Northeast India, and I not only stand to discuss our problems but also to plead on behalf of all the Northeastern states and remind the Union Government regarding their constitutional compulsion for ensuring this border issues and maintaining the security and integrity of the Union of India, as the maintaining the security defense of the borders comes under the central list or the union list. So I would confine my deliberation on three heads. Number one is why border security issues are important. Second, what are the existing problems? And third is how it can be solved. Now, starting with the first one, why borders and security issues are important. The entire northeastern states of India, it has international borders of 5,182 kilometers, sharing with different countries, neighboring countries like China, Bhutan, Myanmar, Tibet, Nepal, and Bhutan. And this particular region is of strategical importance in respect to the security, because now there are problems regarding illegal immigration is of vital importance. And the recent one of being the Rohingya issues, and this immigration from the neighboring country like Bangladesh is an acute problem which is causing a serious threat to the integrity and the security of the region. Along with that, the issues of smuggling of arms and ammunitions and also narcotics is equally important. If it is not taken care of at the present moment, then it could take a larger scale in the coming times. Because I would like to remind the Union government that if the Northeast is not safe, then the eastern part of India is not safe. And if the eastern part of India is not safe, then rest of the country is not safe too. It is because it is a catastrophe will take place. And now let me conclude or sum up with how it can be solved, because it's not discussing about the problems will not settle anything. Now it can be solved, and the central government has much to do, because the northeastern states have a very lesser revenue generation, as there is no huge industry. So first of all, we would like to demand the central government to grant us special financial package for the entire northeastern states, so that they can strengthen their security forces and also strengthen their intelligence agencies in order to fight the cross-border issues of smuggling and terrorism. Then also the fencing of these borders, because many borders are still lying unfenced, so there is smuggling and other clandestine these imports and exports of goods are going on. So the fencing of the border with electrification, that needs to be done on an urgent basis. And at last is that proper coordination should be maintained with all the minister of the northeastern states and along with the minister, home minister of the home department of the Union of India. So with this I conclude, and I thank you all. We hope that our issues would be considered and it will be resolved at the earliest. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you very much, Minister. I now invite the central ministers for their comments.